Thank you very much, moderator of this program, for giving me this opportunity to talk to this important audience. As you mentioned, I'm part of Kibazanga, Christopher is my name, Minister of State for Agriculture, and I come from Uganda. Our host minister, Minister of Agriculture for the Republic of Senegal, African Union officials who are here, the FAO representatives who are here. FAO is our strategic and serious partner in Uganda. The African Development Bank, who are also our strategic partners. My colleague ministers who are here from different countries of Africa. In the name of the Republic of Uganda, and by the appointing authority, the President of the Republic of Uganda, I bring greetings and love to you, dear friends. Today we are discussing rice as a subsector within the Ministry of Agriculture of different countries. As I was listening to the main presenter, I kept on wondering, and I wanted to leave here with an answer so that I take this answer to Uganda. What's wrong with us? What is wrong with us? The region we are discussing, the sub-Sahara, it is the south of the Sahara and the north of the Limpopo River. When you critically examine this region, you discover that Africa is plunging below her weight in as far as rice production is concerned. What is wrong with us? That region alone, if you exploit its potential, it can produce enough rice to feed 1.4 million people of Africa, and we shall have enough for export. But the potential of the region is not really exploited. I am glad that we are here discussing rice as a strategic crop. And indeed, rice is a strategic crop. Why? It is both cash and food crop. In the past, Africa suffered because we started producing crops, only cash crops, which we couldn't consume. But in rice, we have a cash crop and a food crop at the same time. What am I talking about? This food crop, this rice, it at the same time can cause Africa to be food secure. And the moment you are food secure, you know you are about to attain self-independence. Sustainable, you can sustain yourself. You can be food efficient. Rice, it's very strategic because we can also use rice to feed our birds and our animals. We can also add rice in our feeds for our fish. That's why when we are talking about rice, let's not mess up with words. We must be very serious because this is a crop that can ensure the transformation of the agricultural sector. In other words, it can bring more money to our national coffers. This rice we are talking about, it can be able to create employment for our people. The rice we are talking about, it can spark off the industrial revolution within Africa. This rice we are talking about. The rice we are talking about, it can help African countries to deal with our debt burden we have with other countries. My only problem, I don't know, it is because of fashion. We want it to be fashionable. Some countries within the sub-Saharan Africa, they are exporting rice, which is equal to their deficit of the rice they are producing. In other words, you export rice and import the same amount of rice into your country. What are you doing? We are donating money for nothing. You have a deficit of 500 metric tons. You are exporting it. At the same time, you are importing the same amount of rice. This is not being serious. Friends, what we are doing right now in this conference, we are trying to position ourselves. African countries, especially those countries which are south of the Sahara, north of the Limpopo, let us strategically position ourselves for the challenges ahead. Is my time up? What am I communicating? You know very well that climate change is real. Climate change is real. For some countries which are exporting rice now, in the next 20, 30 years, it's going to be very difficult for those countries to produce a kilo of rice. The only opportunity and our only hope is in sub-Saharan Africa. What am I talking about? The demand for food in the next 30 years is hitting $10 trillion. And therefore, if we can resolve in this room that the countries of sub-Saharan Africa can emphasize on producing rice, and not only rice, quality rice, we are going to have a partake of $10 trillion. Dear friends, strategically we must position ourselves. 738 million people of the world are starving. The majority of them are in Latin America, some parts of Asia, and of course Africa, where we have that potential. 738 million people of the world are starving. And if we can produce enough rice to feed them, it is a problem, but at the same time, it's an opportunity. One, for us to feed them. Two, for us to make money. What are we doing in Uganda? First of all, Uganda is both a water tower and a water reservoir of the world. You can't believe it, but that's what we are. A water tower and a water reservoir of the world. And that's what rice needs. Water. And that's why we are described as a pearl of Africa. Even when I'm here, I'm sharing part of the waters that come from Uganda. What are we doing in Uganda? And what do I ask my fellow Africans to do? You will excuse me for repeating what other speakers have hinted to. It is for emphasis. Let us invest in research. Let us invest in research. And here, proudly, I must say, Uganda has the best research institution in the world called NARO, National Agricultural Research Organization. Do I have my officer here? My officer was invited. Using that institution, we have come up with varieties which are high yielding, which are fast maturing, which are drought tolerant and pest resistant. I invite all of you to come and buy these varieties. You come and we make money. Oh yes! Africa, we are hitting 1.4 billion people. So we can do business with ourselves. Why not? So let us invest in our research as we live here. As we live here, and I want you to take this example of Uganda, we have come up with a single spine extension services. And we should add on specialized extension services on rice. Because really, rice can push us into a middle income status. Rice alone, the sub-Saharan countries. Extension services, specialized extension services on rice. Let's continue building the capacity of our farmers. Because sometimes our products are failing to penetrate the world, the international market, because of the quality of the products we are producing. They don't meet the standards. Why? Because the farmers have no capacity. And yet are the product. How many farmers are here? Oh, very good. Farmers, don't be shy. You are the reasons why we are here. Now you can see three after a long struggle. Very good. The capacity of our farmers must be built so that they can produce quality products to penetrate the international market without subjecting them to unnecessary standards. Anyway, those standards will not work within the next 30 years either. Because you will need the food disparity. Value addition must be emphasized. Is my time up? Value addition. Friends, let us stop, especially those countries in the sub-Saharan Africa, north of the Limpopo. Exporting raw material. It's a criminal. Because you are donating anyway. For on top of $4 billion that sub-Saharan Africa is spending in importing rice, you are also exporting rice in its raw form. Time up. Let me not bore you. But also I end with this. Some speakers were saying that we should look for the market. For me, I am saying let us organize the African market. It is there. Everywhere you go in Africa, people are eating rice. In every hotel there is rice. But the market is not organized. And this is, we are talking about 1.4 billion Africans. 1.4 billion Africans is a big market. If we can build their capacity and therefore develop their purchasing power. I thank you, dear Africans. Sometimes when we are addressing the issues of Africa, we are emotional. Because we are behind the development schedule. When others are working, we should run. May God bless you.